NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time. The Crane Room is a restaurant. The Crane Room is a bar. The Crane Room is a banquet facility. The restaurant will please you time after time with their diverse menu. Ask about their daily specials. See the menu at craneroom.com. The bar gives you an abundance of choices with 35 beers on tap and always changing. Their banquet services are always to perfection. The Crane Room, located at 3009 Wilmington Road in Neshannock Township. Call 724-656-1553. InfoCision has been giving job seekers career opportunities for the past 30 years. 150 positions are needed to be filled as soon as possible, and many of them at the Newcastle location. InfoCision handles inbound and outbound customer service and sales calls for the nation's largest nonprofit and leading media and cell phone providers. Come join the InfoCision team that offers excellent benefits. You can call or stop in at 253 East Washington Street, Newcastle. InfoCision, the number one call center company in the world.
Good morning, Newcastle, and welcome to NewsWatch. And before I tell you to get that first cup of coffee, holy cow, we got a lot to talk about. First of all, I always say we read these the day after. And because we want you to get that second piece of birthday cake. In this case, we've gotten so many in. I want to thank the viewers at NCTV45, and I am not going to drop the ball on reading all these names. Connie Moser-Stort, make sure you get that second piece of birthday cake. We wish you a happy birthday. Allison Hood, happy birthday to you. As that in, Mr. John Sarandria, the superintendent of Newcastle Area School District, happy birthday. And Brian Flamino, happy birthday. As these continued to pour in over the weekend from Thanksgiving, Susan Pizzullo Morgan, happy birthday, and make sure you get that second piece of birthday cake. And also Cheryl Russo Shepherd, Rocco Roberts, and Bridget Williams. Make sure that you get that first cup of coffee, that second piece of birthday cake, because NewsWatch is straight ahead for you. I think I'm going to get my coffee now because I'm kind of thirsty after reading all that. We'll be right back after these messages.
The Cedars is a great restaurant with outstanding Mediterranean food. The Cedars takeout menu is second to none, featuring pizza, stromboli, hoagies, their famous lamb on the rod, and so much more. So when you're hungry and you want that Newcastle taste, make it Cedars. Now with two locations in Newcastle, 827 Addis Street on the east side and 1101 Highland Avenue. Call Cedars East, 724-658-9260, or Cedars North, 724-652-7657.
I am never getting married. Ever. Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those.
We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the numbers in life, talk to State Farm agent Michael Joseph in Newcastle. State Farm is there.
Come dine with us, come dine today. If you could use some real good food, there's a place not far away. If you could use a drink or two, or a place to go and play, come to Gallo's Italian Villa today.
Welcome back, and just a reminder that Tuesday, December 1st, there's a 6 p.m. meeting of the New Visions Communication Action Team, and that will be at the Confluence. So make sure you get out at 6 p.m. at the Confluence. Now, keep in mind, the Hoyt has a beautiful art exhibition over there with Miss Signorelli and Miss Wilson. If you get a chance, please check that out. The Hoyt's year-long 50th anniversary celebration may be coming to an end, but a whole new season of programs and activities will be kicking off. There is a holiday open house December 5th from 11 to 4. It's the perfect opportunity to tour the house at their finest, shop the expanded museum gift shop, learn about new classes and workshops this winter. Free gift wrap and refreshments will be available. Bring the kids for free activities and books. And children won't want to miss story time with local author Patricia Galbraith as she reads Merry House in Our Father's House at 1 p.m. In the mood for music, well, Nanette Kaplan Solomon will be playing the recently gifted Steinway piano in the Hoyt West at 2 p.m., followed by a short program by the Newcastle High School Senior High Music Theater at 3 p.m. Doors will open at 6:30 for an evening concert. Sounds of the Season will feature the Westminster Chamber Concert Choir singers, conducted by Dr. Samuel Barber, with guests Jean DiCaprio, Kathy Bessler Mansell, and Eric McClellan. The program begins at 7. Admission is free, but reservations are requested by calling 724-652-2882. And you know, you can visit the HoytArtCenter.org for more information. Take a look at some of the things the Hoyt brings to Newcastle. And this also in from the Hoyt, and it seems like there's just so much in that area of art that gets neglected sometimes. The Hoyt first opened its doors in 1965, keeping the arts alive in the heart of Lawrence County. Nowhere is it more important than in the Hoyt's preeminent collection, which illustrates a timeline growth and the change over the last 50 years. It is therefore fitting that the arts and education at the Hoyt end the year with collections and reflections, a section of painting and collages, prints, enamels, ceramics, and more, complemented by articles and newsletters from the archives. With the exhibition begins the foundation of the early collection in the Blair Sculptor Walkway. Driven by a passion of artists and art enthusiasts, the collection reflects those that were responsible for establishing the Hoyt in the 60s and 70s. Names like Phyllis Blair, Tom McNichol, Nelson Ostrich, Fred Alexander, Scott McGuire, and Robert Heidel appear repeatedly throughout the archives alongside the museum's first director, George Faddis, Carbis Walker, and William Craig McBurney. In fact, Carbis Walker donated the museum's very first piece, Cabin in the Woods. The exhibition advances from the walkway into the West Gallery, which sections from the 80s to the 90s, the annual Hoyts regional and national exhibits were introduced. With them, a new resource to build the permanent collection under the administrators of Dave Ludwig, Susan Miller, Linda Lambert. It was within this era that the Hoyt acquired the Hoyt West and then constructed the Blair sculpted walkway to link the Arts Center with the new period home. The collections moved from the East Gallery reflected the acquisition of the 21st century under director Kim Kohler-Jones, who is there now till the present. Continued facility reservations permitted a high caliber of exhibition to be forged through new relationships with private collectors, museums. As the Hoyt began to host prominent figures from American history, they began to collect such works as Wolf Kahn, Romare Bearden, and Robert Motherwell. The museum's newest collection include William Partridge Burpee pastels gifted by the Jerrold Marburger Gallery in honor of the museum's 50th anniversary. Several new displays have also been installed in the Hoyt East, including the collection of vintage opera posters in the Red Room, an extensive display of decals, designs, photographs, dinnerware in the adjacent J. Howard Bruce Shenango China Room. Take a peek into the museum's collective decorative collections in the Hoyt West Period House, including a new collection of silver flatware that dates back to the 1800s. Collections and reflections will be on display in the Hoyt's main galleries through January 15th, and admission is free. Now, you know, I tell you, there's a lot going on at that art place, art center up there, the Hoyt. I call it a museum or gallery. That's just my opinion because they do so very much. And let's not forget about this. Anastasia Constance and Clone have teamed up with Two Rivers Artisan Coffee to create an Arabian coffee night. On this night, they will showcase Allure Art Rags Sherry known, and this is supposed to be December 4th at 8 p.m. So make sure you check that event out. You know, great things going on in the castle all the time. And right after these messages, we're going to be back to tell you about a whole lot more. Stay with us. Tuscany Square Restaurant, 3470 Wilmington Road, where old world charm meets today's modern conveniences. You'll enjoy their spacious, comfortable seating, their fresh ingredients that go into making every dish, whether it's pizza or that just right entree. Tuscany Square Restaurant, they're here to serve you. Call 724-654-3065. It's time to go to Chilella and Carney, floral design artists. For flowers, plants, figurines, and so much more, whether you're celebrating that special day, that special engagement, anniversary, birthday, you name it, Chilella and Carney has what you need. At 1006 South Mill Street, it's Chilella and Carney. The Beanery Depot and Deli. Coffee, made-to-order subs, snacks, and more. Meatball sandwiches, fresh and hot. Pepperoni rolls, fish sandwiches, chicken, milkshakes. The Beanery Deli. When you're hungry for something special, and it won't cost you a lot of beans. Yes, I'm in Mr. Pizza. Hi, we're here with...
Sydney.
And it looks like you girls have had a great lunch. Can you tell me what you have, Sydney?
The ham and cheese sub.
Oh, today's special. What did you have?
I had pepperoni pizza and part of the ham and cheese sub. And they were both very good.
Hey, it's always best when you get your food in somebody else's. And here at Mr. Pizza, what a great time. Stop down. Check out the special. This program furnished by Melzer's Fuel Service. Melzer's. Since 1977. Daryl Knight, Territorial Manager. Welcome back, and just a few notes that are kind of important here as we get to more top stories today in Newcastle, PA. First of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to talk about the Speedway gas station that seems to have everybody all brimming and fired up. Lord knows we got enough emails. Yes, they're thinking of and may put and probably will a Speedway gas station in the city. Now, in case you haven't recognized, cars need gasoline to go. And as I look around this wonderful county, I see that there's a similar gas station in Neshannock. I see that there's a similar gas station in Union. And also, one out on 224, the Butler Road, in Shenango. Now, as I look towards other areas, even Laurel has one of those types of gas stations that are bigger than your average 1970s type gas station. So the question then becomes, why not Newcastle? You know, as they think and as you think of these things passing by, keep in mind that we do not have a gas station in the downtown area. For people that travel in from out of town, it becomes a little cumbersome trying to figure out where to get gas before you leave. Second, there is a tax base. And anytime you can add to your tax base, that sounds like a good thing to me. And it just may brighten up an area where there's no activity at all. So keep that in mind. I personally don't think the gas station will be a harm, but a plus to an already great castle. And let's make sure that the buildings that we have here, we take care of, renovate, and continue to make this the greatest castle in the world. Now, in other news, for those looking for us on Comcast 183, there's still no audio here in the city, but I was told that Armstrong and the other cable companies, it worked just fine. Remember that Tuesday was the last and is the last Downtown Business Association meeting at the Chamber. So make sure that you don't go walking over there expecting there to be something that might not be there. Keep in mind that LIHEAP is in effect for those low-income families or individuals that need help with heating and electric. bills that is available. It is also the open enrollment period for the Affordable Care Act, and it's going to be late December before Old Plank Road is finished with that construction that they have up there. So if you can, by all means, avoid the area. Keep in touch with the Newcastle Y through My Y text alerts. Text YMC member to 84483. And keep in touch with the goings-on at the YMCA. You can also go to rainedout.com, and they'll email you those alerts also. Now, we're going to be right back with so much more after these messages. Hello, friends. Are you a person on the go? Do you need snacks, cookies, maybe just a deli sandwich, lottery, or gas? It's Gino's in Mahoning Town for all your needs. Stop by Gino's and tell them NCTV45 sent you. Arlington Market, located at 726 Arlington Avenue, has all the great food you remember. Yes, their canned goods are fantastic and feature that old world taste. And meat, cheeses, produce, lunch meats, fresh cut meats, groceries, and so much more. It's Arlington Market. It'll make your table look spectacular.
It's Butts Flowers in downtown Newcastle for fine gifts and more. Flowers, 120 East Washington Street, Newcastle, with a wide variety of flowers for any occasion. Call Butts Flowers, 724-652-7727, or toll free from anywhere, 1-800-443-7726. It's Butts Flowers in downtown Newcastle.
Welcome back, and you know, as this holiday season progresses, quite a few things going on in the greatest castle in the world, and let's kind of put these in order for you. December 4th, it's Christmas in the Park. Over there in New Wilmington, they'll be lighting up New Wilmington, they'll have parades, and so much more. So make sure you get out December 4th to take a look at what's going on in New Wilmington. And now, you know, that's not all. December 4th and 5th, at the other end of the county, it's Light Up Night down in Elwood City. Yes, such things as a barbecue, and don't forget the concert on Friday night with Jana Filotico and Rudy Zest. And I probably said that backwards, but they are so great. And that's just that night. They're having a screening of It's a Wonderful Life at the Lincoln High School. And then on Saturday, they have a DJ, Greg Marshall, on the plaza, and also a parade, and they're lighting up Ewing Park. Now, right here in the center of it all in Newcastle, starting at 9 o'clock, there's a craft show at the Newcastle Junior Senior High School, and there's also Breakfast with Santa from 9 to 11. Adults $5, children 3 and over will be $3, and children 2 and under are free. Now, from that, there's the Holly Jolly Holiday Express Tour right here in downtown Newcastle. It's an interactive walking tour through the historic downtown and debuts Saturday, December 5th at 1 at the Confluence. Now, keep in mind that from 9 to 1, the Confluence has some hot chocolate and pictures with Santa going on. Conductors will lead you through the various stations where you will be entertained, taste cultural cookies, and fashion holiday crafts from the top, from the each stop, you will collect tickets and enter in a drawing at the Riverplex. And this is what I think is really exciting, and you may have seen this on NCTV45 over the past few days. They're going to have a movie. They're showing Polar Express in the Riverplex at 7 o'clock. And, you know, what just an unbelievable amount of activities here. They're talking about creating your own personal holiday card at the Pokeberry Exchange, cultural cookies, an open house. Let the holiday spirit move you, with Haney's Furniture getting involved. Create your own holiday ornament, prizes, pictures with special guests, hoop spirits, and more at the Riverplex. It's a collaboration, and it will build you up, and you will experience and recall these treasured moments from Christmas past, as well as the new traditions you will make with family and friends. Enjoy downtown Newcastle and the merchants there. And NCTV 45 looks forward to welcoming you on your way through the greatest castle in the world. And keep this in mind, that Sunday, December 6th at 2 p.m. at the Scottish Rite Cathedral, it's the Newcastle Regional Ballet's rendition of The Nutcracker. So make sure you get your tickets for that. The Spiritual Path Church welcomes Dupring Gong Buddhist monks December 6th through the 12th for a week of prayers and healing, as well as 6 days of building of a sacred sand medallion. Medallion means world harmony, and there are three dimensions of the sand drawings. The sand medallia is carefully constructed from dying sand particles to generate compassion, realize the importance of reality, and the social cosmic healing environment. Reverend Karen Heasley, pastor of the Spiritual Path Church, stated, "This is truly a unique experience. Everyone should experience at least once in their lifetime." So Sunday, December 6th is the opening ceremony. All week long, patrons may observe the building of the medallia at the Spiritual Path Church. During the hours of 10 a.m. to 5, the entire week is filled with lectures, healing, to overcome negativity and overall well-being. The meditation and the sand medallion workshop. The closing ceremonies will be Saturday, December 12th at 5 with Momo, Tibet dumpling, and potluck dinner. Participants to the Momo are encouraged to bring a covered dish for the potluck dinner, and a $10 suggested donation. The Spiritual Path Church is located at 2041 Moravia Street Extension in Newcastle. For more information, call 724-698-7564. Now, there's more on the way. Make sure that you stay tuned. We'll be right back after these messages. Pegley's Pasta & More. When you're hungry for that great Italian taste, bellissimo, it is tremendous. You have to stop by Pegley's for pasta, sandwiches, pizza. Yes, it's Pegley's Pasta & More. For that great Italian taste, it's not just for Sunday anymore. Head over to Pegley's.
Whether it's a scheduled appointment or same-day service, DiCaprio Carpet Cleaning offers 24/7 service for commercial, industrial, and residential, as well as fire and water damage restoration. Using state-of-the-art technology, DiCaprio Carpet Cleaning experts are ready to professionally clean your carpet today. Call DiCaprio Carpet Cleaning for a free in-home estimate. Thank you for making us Lawrence and Mercer County's largest carpet cleaner.
And remember, nobody gets your carpet cleaner.
If you're having a party, then Keystone Specialty is the place you need to go. Yes, they have every party supply that you can imagine. Planning that wedding, that graduation, or maybe it's just that big game that's coming up, go to Keystone Specialty. Party supplies and so much more. Remember, they have those fall decorations, winter, spring, and summer. It's Keystone Specialty on the south side of Newcastle, Mill Street. This program furnished by Sporting Goods, 23 East Washington Street, Newcastle. Call 724-658-2535. Well, welcome to, yes, it's the Cedar Sports Corner. And, you know, sometimes you have to use something over and over again. And after this guy saw Padula, he went to the Baltimore-Cleveland game. What was the guy's name? Win one soon, as Baltimore, which was Cleveland 1, took on Cleveland 2. Both with pretty dismal records. And what can I say? That was the Monday night football game. The other scores from the past weekend are streaming across your screen. Now, in the NHL, well, let's take a look at what's going on. And, you know, the Penguins, as they continue through this young season. We all saw that hit leveled on Sidney Crosby. Now, the Pens are not in action until Tuesday, well, tonight, and they're at San Jose. That's probably why. I was looking, and I said, nobody's at the console. Probably because the Pens are not there. They will take on San Jose on Tuesday, and then they will return to Pittsburgh to take on, no, they're going to stay out there. They're going to take on Los Angeles on Saturday. They just have had too much of a good time. And in the NBA, let's take a look at how the Cavs are doing. My son's yelling to me, how about the Spurs? And Nick's over there yelling, how about Boston? Well, Boston played Miami last night. And as we look to tonight, it is the Washington Wizards at Cleveland. And, Ange, I am getting to your favored Spurs. But it looks like they're taking some days for rest and relaxation. They might be taking after you a little bit because they are not on this schedule for Monday or Tuesday. Now, keep in mind that NCTV45 will be carrying high school basketball. We are your center for high school sports here in Lawrence County, so make sure that you check that out. This was the Cedars Sports Corner. And we're going to be right back after these messages.
Joshua Sun Rehabilitation Center. From the moment you arrive, you know that you're in the right place. Dr. John Wrightson listens first. He pays attention to detail and then makes the determination. Joshua Sun Rehabilitation. We make the pain go away.
Hello, folks. Angelo Perrotta for Ferrone Brothers. Wow, you have to try their food. Great Italian food and two locations on the south side on Mill Street and on Wilmington Road in Newcastle. Ferrone Brothers for pepperoni rolls, pizza, any Italian dish that you can imagine. Okay, and a whole lot more. It's Ferrone Brothers. Stop by. They have those daily specials, and they look forward to seeing you. Tell them NCTV45 sent you.
Gentlemen, if you want to look your best with high-quality clothing, then I recommend Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors in downtown Newcastle. Mike Caggiano is the owner, and he and his staff have been in the business for decades, and they will always give you the right recommendations. They also carry Rondinelli tuxedos. That's Main Street Clothiers and Custom Tailors, 210 East Washington Street, downtown Newcastle. Call 724-652-3851.
Welcome back. And continuing on with our top stories, the 75th anniversary of the Messiah was at St. Vitus Church, and it was absolutely outstanding, as you can see in these pictures. Many people enjoyed the festivities, and as we enter into these holidays, let's remember the reason for the season. Let's keep Christ in Christmas. Now, many people also, and we informed you about this, the Festival of the Trees at Neshaddock Elementary School, to benefit the Newcastle Public Library. Take a look at some of these fine pictures. What a great time was had by all. My daughter happened to be able to go up there, and she had an absolute gorgeous and great time. Now, you know, we welcome anybody that has any related news items to bring them in as my papers stick together. So I'm going to go down this, and, you know, there's different holy days of obligation in the Catholic Church, but keep in mind that we're free. Any worship services that any denominations have, please send them to us at nctv45@gmail.com, and we'll get them on. Now, December 7th, it's a Monday, and it's the vigil of a holy day of obligation, the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. St. Vincent de Paul will have 4 o'clock Mass. There will be a 3 o'clock Mass at Westminster College, 3:15 at Mary Mother of Hope, 7 p.m. at St. Vitus, and 7 p.m. at Christ the King, St. Lawrence Church. I wanted to make sure on that Westminster College because it was a 3 o'clock time. Now, keep in mind that as we talk about this Advent season in anticipation of Christmas, Advent penance services will begin at 7 o'clock. And here is a schedule. Tuesday, December 4th, Holy Redeemer. Wednesday, December 9th, Mary Mother of Hope and Holy Redeemer Parish. Tuesday, December 10th, and that will be at St. Joseph the Worker. Monday, December 14th, at Christ the King, St. Anthony's. Tuesday, December 15th, Holy Redeemer. Wednesday, December 16th at St. Vincent de Paul. Thursday, December 17th at St. James the Apostle. Monday, December 21st at St. Camillus. And Tuesday, December 22nd at St. Vitus and Holy Redeemer. Now, I want to remind you that churches of all denominations are welcome to send in any schedule or any information on their worship services, church festivals, or goings on during the holiday season and any time throughout the year. You can send that in to nctv45@gmail.com or send us a text or call 724-510-7345 or send a text to 724-498-5507. Now, we're going to be back with a whole lot more right after these messages.
Dineo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters. Serving Newcastle, Elwood City, and Youngstown. Dineo and Olson handles criminal law, bankruptcy, civil matters, workers' compensation, personal injury, medical malpractice, divorce, wills, real estate, and many more legal issues. Call any one of their offices in Newcastle, Elwood City, or Youngstown with these phone numbers. Open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. Dineo and Olson Law Group, where every client matters.
Whether it's time to fix the furnace, throw the salt, shovel the drive, it's Paul D. Weller Hardware. We have what you need. Whether it's time to get warm, make the macaroni, make the ravioli, make the pizzas, throw another log on the fire, or get ready for Christmas, it's Paul D. Weller Hardware. Hey, let's go sled ride.
Bill's Bake Shop will make you happy. Owner Bill Cast and his staff keep the tradition going with all those bakery items you remember as a kid. Just to name a few, Bill makes cream sticks, cinnamon rolls, bear claws, cream horns, cannoli, cakes, pies, cookies, bread, pizza, and more. You can also buy homemade cavatelli ravioli. Bill's Bake Shop, located 228 North Liberty Street in the Mahoningtown section of Newcastle, is open Tuesday through Saturday, 7 to 5, and Sunday, 7 to 2, closed Monday. Bill's, where smiles are everywhere. Call 724-654-4223.
Welcome back. And now it's time for Crane Room 45 weather. Yes, expect showers, because last night the rain came down and the temperature was 39, and your Tuesday's not looking any different, as you'll reach a high of 55 with an 80% chance of rain. Tuesday night, showers likely before midnight with a low of 38. And Wednesday, a chance of showers mainly after 11 a.m., mostly cloudy with a high of 46. The chance of rain Wednesday is 40%. Wednesday night, showers and rain continue. Snow showers between 9 and 2 a.m. And yes, the chance of snow showers increases after 2 a.m. Mostly cloudy, a low of 33, and the chance of precipitation, 40%. Now, Thursday, and I haven't said this a long time, Gary, but break out that suntan lotion. Partly sunny with a high of 43. Thursday night with an overnight low of 29. And Friday, mostly sunny with a high of 47. Partly cloudy Friday night with a low of 30, just right for those outdoor activities. And Saturday, sunny with a high of 49. Saturday night, partly cloudy with a low of 31. And Sunday, mostly sunny with a high of 49. Now, Gary, you know, you told me if I got some sunshine into this forecast, you would make sure I had something to eat. And me being a great guy, and my son, 2x2, being right with me, We call them 2x2. That's a little inside joke. We just wanted you to know that the Beanery Depot and Deli has a Reuben on Tuesday, hot ham and Swiss with cabbage soup also, and pot roast sandwich on Wednesday, tuna melts and wedding soup. Thursday, wings, turkey and provolone, ham and bean soup. And Friday, it's their fish, mac and cheese, okay? And they have a fish chowder also. So, Gary, you know, I got you some sunshine. I told you where you could get some food on your way up to come and visit me. So make sure that you do that, because this was Crane Room 45 weather, and we're going to be back with a wrap-up right after this. Wow, yes, it's fun to go to the Y, and now with great affordable rates, it's more swimming, more exercise, more family time. The YMCA in downtown Newcastle, or the Y Zone on Eleanor Drive in Shannon Township, welcomes you to a variety of programs, exercise, and fun events.
If you're craving pizza and more, then Little Johnny's too wants you to come through the door. Their menu includes many pizza varieties, jumbo wings, hoagies, calzones, strombolis, flatbread sandwiches, bread bowl salads, soups, and more. Dine in, take out, or have them delivered. Little Johnny's too can even cater your next party. Their prices are right, and the food is the way you expect it. Little Johnny's 2 is located at 130 East Washington Street in downtown Newcastle. Call 724-657-2210.
Welcome back. And this in from the Sharon Regional Health System in Sharon, PA. Sharon Regional School of Nursing extends its application deadline. The new deadline is set for the class starting August 2016. February 29th, 2016 is the extended deadline to apply to Sharon Regional's Health Systems School of Nursing for the next class starting August 2016. That will graduate on May 2018. Those interested must complete an application and take the ATITEAS entrance exam, which is administered by the School of Nursing. Through a partnership with Penn State Shenango, the Sharon Regional offers area residents the unique opportunity to seamlessly earn a diploma in the nursing field from the School of Nursing and a bachelor's degree in nursing from Penn State Shenango. Financial aid is available. The demand for qualified registered nurses continues to grow in our region and throughout the country, stated Tracy Ryan, MSN, RNCNE, director of the Sharon Regional Health System. The School of Nursing, we are proud of the fact that students can earn their RN diploma in 5 semesters. The program's job placement rate remains over 90%, and our graduates are working in the nursing field as full-time healthcare providers. Accredited by the Accreditation Commission for Education and staffed by Master's Prepared Facility, the graduating class of 2015 achieved 100% pass rate on the NCLEX-RN, which administers licensing programs to professional nurses. For more information, call the school at 724-983-3865 or visit sharonregional.com/schoolnursing.htm for an application package and more information. So there you go on that. Thanks to Sharon Regional for sending that in. Sharon Regional has also announced today that it has been recognized as a 2014 top performer on key quality measures. The Joint Commission and the leading accreditor of health organizations in the United States. The Sharon Regional System was recognized as part of the Joint Commission's 2015 annual report, America's Hospitals, Improving Quality and Safety for Attaining and Sustaining Excellence in Accountability, Measure the Performance for Heart Attack, Heart Failure, Pneumonia, Surgical Care, and Immunizations. Sharon Regional Health System is one of only 1,043 hospitals out of more than 3,000 eligible hospitals in the United States to achieve the 2014 Top Performer distinction. The Top Performer program recognizes hospitals for improving performance on evidence-based interventions that increase the chances of healthy outcomes for patients with certain conditions. The performance measures include in the recognition program are heart attack, heart failure, pneumonia, surgical care, children's asthma, inpatient psychiatric services, stroke, venous thrombosis, parental care, immunization, tobacco treatment, and substance use. To be a top performer, hospitals had to meet three performance criteria based on the 2014 accountability measuring data, and that included active cumulative performance of 95% or above across all reported accountability measures, achievement performance of 95% or above on each and every reported accountability measure with at least 30 denominator cases, have at least one core measure set that had a composite rate of 95% or above, with that measure set, achieve a performance of 95% or above on all applicable individual accountability measures. And that one was thrombolism. So they continue on to say, delivering the right treatment in the right way at the right time is a cornerstone of high-quality health care. I commend the efforts of Sharon Regional for their excellent performance on the use of the evidence-based intervention, said Mark R. Chasm, MD, FACP, MP, President and CEO of the Joint Commission. We understand what matters most to patients at Sharon Regional, and it is the quality and safety of the care they receive. That is why we have made it a top priority to improve the positive patient outcomes through evidence-based care process, says Jack Roebuck, CEO of Sharon Regional Health System. We are extremely proud to be named a top performer, as it recognizes the knowledge, teamwork, and dedication of our entire staff. For more information about the Top Performer Program, please visit jointcommission.org, accreditation, top performers, ASPX. Hats off to Sharon Regional for achieving such a fine standing in the community. Now, I wanted to bring this out that there is a mixer at 7 p.m. December 16th, Christmas mixer for New Visions. It's at the Confluence, 214 East Washington Street. You're cordially invited to join the fun. Volunteers, come and enjoy the holiday spirit and do some community building. It's a great time of the year to reflect and gather to make sure you're in there with your New Visions family. So it looks to be a great time for that mixer at New Visions. Congratulations to the Sharon Regional Health System. And we're going to be right back after these messages. Funding for this program provided by Washington Center Physical Therapy, Norm A. Gabriel, MSPT, ATC owner. This program furnished by the MAD Unit, Mobile Auto Detailing. See Michael Sad at themadunit.com. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
There's more than meets the eye. Got a gift from the Newcastle I tried. The right small town for living. Look around.
Oh, oh. Well, welcome back. Yeah. And boy, I'll tell you what, I want to thank everybody for over that Thanksgiving weekend heating up the email here at NCTV 45. We had quite a few stories all emailed in from everywhere, the governor on down to the east side, west side, north side, all around the town. And I thank you. But more importantly, for this December 1st, before you get caught up in all that hustle and bustle, very important to make sure you get that second cup of coffee. And by all means, have a super day in what I call the greatest castle in the world, in the county of Lawrence. Have a great day, everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow.